take pride in it. Because my thing is, how you are there is how you're gonna be into the, you know, when you get the job that you want.
I'm a vlogger, a video blogger.
What's up, y'all? Good morning, good morning, good morning. It is Tuesday, 9:15. I have an 11:30 dentist appointment, then to work. So here doing some work. And yeah, just probably saying good morning, y'all. Catch y'all outside.
10:54. I'm about to head to my 11:30 appointment. I just wanted to jump in here real quick. You know, I've been on YouTube for a minute. I enjoy YouTube. You know, it's a hobby. Yeah, you make the little coins in there, but again, it's not my bread and butter. I just want to say, anyone who wants to start YouTube, don't be discouraged. Because I mean, I'm in this for a minute, and it's like, you know, I follow a lot of, I guess you want to call them content creator gurus. Yeah, that's their niche. Yeah. And it's a niche that's never gonna, I mean, hey, maybe that's something you want to try, become one of them. But it's just all this algorithm, that, it will make anyone discouraged. Because every year it's a new freaking algorithm with YouTube. It's like, whatever happened to just enjoying, you know, just enjoying this platform? I mean, there's some like myself, yeah, I'm not conforming to, you know, okay, doing all this tag shit and let order, you know, not saying I would never, I mean, I've done some, not saying I wouldn't do some, but that's like, you know, that's not what my content is going to. What the hell are you parking here for, bitch? Why are you parking here? Move your shit. Someone just pull up. Move your freaking car. But it's like, it's a lot of pressure every time you see these things. How to get more subscribers. I am so grateful for y'all. For the constant people that watch my vlogs. Because again, I've said it before. You look at my subscribers and look at the video view count. It doesn't match up. Because again, when I, way back, a lot of people were coming and subscribing because I used to give away cameras. But I stopped doing that stuff because it's like, yo, are you here to watch me or to get free shit? So I'd rather people who's here to watch me and enjoy what I do. You know, there's strength in few, and I'm good with that. You know, and it's funny because the accounts that are subscribed, they're actual accounts, because YouTube flushes, you know, fake accounts and all that. And my shit is still, so it's like, and it still happens today. So that's why I don't do a lot of please subscribe. My thing is, subscribe if you want to watch what I do. I'm just a regular person. I share my day-to-day life. Yeah. Basically, living in Brooklyn, New York, that's what I do. Because, I mean, I like the community that you can build here on YouTube, that I have built here on YouTube. And I just want to encourage anyone that wants to start vlogging, don't be discouraged. Do your thing. Be you. Stay in your lane. And what's yours is going to be for you. 10:55, I need to get on the road. And because I got to find parking. Done at the dentist, 12:17. Trying to head to work. She came to you, or you get a bag of goodies. I don't know how good your dentist was. She came with this bag. I'm like, what? I'm like, that's different. And she's a little smaller, cute little Listerine bag. But she's like, Listerine, they don't give samples anymore, so they don't get the bag. Sons of bitches. So what I got? I got a new toothbrush. I hate this toothpaste, but I need it because I got sensitive, girl. I don't fuck with this, yo. I like the one on the stick. I don't like this one because I can't gauge it and bust up my gums. Anyway, now it's hot. It wasn't hot earlier. It wasn't really, yeah, so. Why is my phone vibrating? What do I have on vibrate?
Tell me now, tell me something. Cause I don't know how this gonna end. Oh no. Tell me now, tell me something. Cause I don't wanna be just friends. No, no. Yeah.
So that was a short day.
came and did what I needed to do. You know. Shut the hell up, y'all. The light just changed, you dick. Yeah. I'm about to go in and edit some reviews. I'm debating if I want to do a load of laundry. I probably will. It's just damn hot. It's 89 degrees. Bitch, you want to pass? Go, go, you fucking dick. Go ahead, go ahead. Go, 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 you dumb hillbilly hick. Shit. To go stay there. Where the fuck you going? You dumb fuck. Where the fuck they beeping me like I'm supposed to go somewhere? Go on, you dumb idiot. You got very far. I just let him pass. What the fuck you keep beeping me for? Shit. Fucking dumb asshole. So I just came out of Dollar Tree. Yo, the line was fairly long when I got it. You know, come, you been to Dollar Tree, shit. Dollar Tree is shit. Going with $10, you come out rich, bitch. But there was one teller, and I was like, this is crazy. So a girl's coming behind it, and she on her phone. Bitch, you don't see the line? And she steady. She take her customer, go back, and then she on her phone text. She said next, and I went up there, she on the phone. I was giving her a few minutes. I'm gonna be like, yo, can you get off your phone? I want to see your manager. Like, I understand. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if it's the way I'm brought up or whatever, but I don't even know if it has to do anything when you're brought up or just a respect for yourself. Like, if you don't want to work in Dollar Tree, don't work in Dollar Tree. You know, it may not be the dream job, but if you take pride in it, because my thing is, how you are there is how you're going to be into the, you know, when you get the job that you want. Like, come on, how you gonna be trusted with greater if you can't do good with what you have? Anyway.
Time. What's up, y'all? Good morning. Happy Wednesday. Happy hump day. 8:23, just leaving the house, watching the news. They're talking again about the whole bicycle thing. It was like they called it a die-in. They sat in where was the city hall? What, you know, sitting by cyclists. They say I think it's a 509 more have died this year. Now listen, and I'm looking at a bicyclist. Good, he's waiting on the light. Great. Half of these bicyclists do not obey the law. The last one that killed, she was crushed by a construction cement truck. The cement truck had the green light. See, now right now, this woman standing. Oh my God, these signs, it used to be a number countdown. Now they put pictures, so it's like, damn it, if you can't read, you see the damn picture. So anyway, she was, you know, they showed the, I guess it was a traffic, you know, the cam, the police have all over the place, picked it up and you see it. My thing is, you can't blame that on the cement truck alone, because if the cement truck had the green light, why the hell are you going into the road? The whole thing about, oh, even with, oh, what, the pedestrians having a right of way, bitch, if it's green, why no, you do not cross the road. It's like, I'm a driver, and then, you know, I walk in the street, and being a driver, I'm really mindful, because it's like, I can be on, you know, opposites, you know, I can see the safety hazards or the safety risks on both sides. I see kids riding their bikes across the street. No, you're supposed to dismount and walk it across. It's easier, God forbid something happens, shit, throw it, run, drop that bike and run, or, you know, bicyclists do not obey the law, so I believe both should be held accountable, the car and the bike. Yes, the car is heavier and is kill you, badow. But if you're not obeying the law, you can't put that on me. Again, when I saw the clip of the woman being, and the thing is, they say it, the cement truck had the green light. So then what? Yeah. So I just got to work on my way in, coming up about to, what street is that?
because I'm going into Bedford to turn. But anyway, driving one lane. The bicycle lane is to my right. There's a bicycle. He's just driving along, not in the bicycle lane, on the wrong side. So I pull up to him. I say, sir, why don't you go in the bicycle lane? Or he get mad. Nigga, this is why anytime I hear this shit on the news, I don't want to hear this shit because they don't obey the law either. Yeah. I'm sorry for those who got killed, but those of you who have sense understand what I'm saying. If they're not obeying the law, you can't hold cars responsible alone. So all of that, I'm sorry. Bye, y'all, bye. Yeah, y'all have a wonderful day.